Hello everyone, good morning. Today is May 21, 2021. So, to my fellow OFWs around the world, magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. And yung nasa Pilipinas, good morning. It is already 9:41 in the morning. So, as usual, we are here to check the movement of the Philippine Stock Exchange Index as of 9:41 in the morning. Tingnan natin kung ano yung movement ni PECI. But before we proceed, this is only a disclaimer that there is no recommendation to buy, to sell, or to hold your positions if you have shares of the companies that we are going to discuss today. The purpose of this discussion is only for educational purposes, to study the support and resistance. So we know that the support and resistance is very much important in the stock market, because the support, this is the area where there is a heavy buying, and the resistance, this is the area where there is a heavy selling. So we need to avoid buying shares if it is in the resistance area, and we need to check always if there is opportunity to buy in the support area if there is a bounce. But not all the times the support ay mag-hold, and the same with the resistance, not all the times na may pull back if the price is going in the resistance area. There is a possibility that the resistance ay may break going up, and the same with the support. There is a possibility that the support ay may broken down. So if you buy in the support area and then the support ay may break, then of course you need to cut your losses. So there is a risk management where you will cut your losses. So let's go to the chart of the Philippine Stock Exchange Index. As of 9:43 in the morning, PECI is down by 0.10%. So if we check the movement of the PECI, still this inclined resistance ay hindi pa rin na break ni PECI, this upper line of the channel. So resistant po yan, kasi diyan nauntog yung price, and then there's a pullback, and then going up, there's another pullback. It means this area, this line is a resistant area. So we need the PECI to break that resistant area para mas maganda naman yung movement pag ma-break yan. But as of now, still downtrend pa rin yung PECI. It is below the two exponential moving averages, the 50 and 200, this green line. So nandito naman si PECI sa my horizontal support, this horizontal line. And how many days here now? Almost I think 1 week na nandito si PECI. So it's trying to break this horizontal support, but there is a bounce last Friday, no? May 14, 2021. He's trying to break it, but there is a pullback. But we need to see today kung mag-hold pa rin si PECI. If you see the area here, paliit ng paliit na po yung area dito sa may bandang horizontal line. So we need to see kung ma-break ba ni PECI yung support, or he will break this incline resistance. So tingnan natin, sana mag-hold. Nandito pa naman siya sa may horizontal support. So we'll see the movement of PECI until 1 o'clock in the afternoon Philippine time. So we'll see. We'll see MWC, Manila Water. Tingnan natin yung Manila Water. So as of 9:45, the most active here is dito, followed by VLL. And the top gainers is PXP. He's up by 20.6%. And the top losers is ME. So we'll see the bigger picture of Manila Water Company. So this line here, the inclined line, this is the resistance. Because when the price going up to this area, there is a pullback. So if you see here, there is a pullback. So this is a resistant area, and then he's going down and trying to going up and then pull back again, and then he's create a new resistant here, and then there's a pullback. So hindi po makalabas yung price if the price is in the resistant area. So now it's going up and then hitting again this line here. This is a resistant, and then he is in the resistant area as of now. So nandito na naman si Manila Water sa may resistant area. So hindi po niya na break yan. There are 3 times here he's trying to hit this area, but he did not break it. But for me, my own opinion, I will wait if there is a breakout of this incline resistant. Because if there is no breakout, there is a possibility that this support ay ma-breakdown ni Manila Water. Of course, kung ma-break yan, the price will going down again. So we need to watch this incline resistant na ma-break ni Manila Water Company. So take note, Manila Water, it is in the resistant area. So if ever ma-break ni MWC this incline resistant, we need to see if there is a pattern created and after he break this incline resistant. So ingat-ingat po tayo, nasa resistant area si Manila Water. So we need to wait if there is a breakout of that incline resistant. PERC, we need to watch, we need to check the movement of PERC. Kung ano yung movement ni Petro Energy Resources Corporation. So if you see the bigger picture na here, this area here, this is the resistant. Okay. Now when he break it, he's going sideways and he's going up. And nauntog na naman siya dito sa area na ito. Then this is called as resistant area. So he's going down and then he's trying to going up, and he's following this incline support, this line here. So nasa resistant area si PERC ngayon. And if I have a position for PERC, I need to wait if this incline support po ito, kasi nag-bounce po yung price dito. If ever ma-break ni PERC this line, so of course I need to go exit if ever ma-break ni PERC this horizontal or incline support. So kung tingnan natin ngayon, nasa resistant na naman, hit niya this line last April 20 or May 3, but there is a rejection. So we need to see if there is a breakout for PERC. So we need to be, you don't want to be aggressive for PERC now until there is a breakout of the incline resistant. And provided that this support ay mag-hold. Just watch the support na mag-hold. RCI. Si RCI. Tingnan natin si RCI. Ano yung movement ng RCI. So the bigger picture for RCI. This area is the incline resistance. So nauntog po siya dyan, there's a pullback. Resistant again, there's a pullback. And then still he is below on this resistant area. So for me, I will wait if there is a breakout of this incline resistant for RCI. Just check this horizontal support na hindi ma-break ni RCI. If ever ma-break yan, of course the price will going down again. So just watch this incline resistant na ma-break ni RCI. But if ever, don't be aggressive for RCI. So that is my own opinion, but it's depend on your trading strategy. But for me, I will wait if there is a breakout of that incline resistance. So let's check RRHI. Tingnan natin yung RRHI. Kung ano po yung price movement ni RRHI. So ito po yung resistance ni RRHI. There is a pullback, and now we need to wait if RRHI will going back to the bottom line of this channel. So don't be aggressive for RRHI now. We need to wait if there is a price movement, another price movement for RRHI. So I hope you learned something about this discussion. If you have comments, just put your comments in the comments box and we will discuss, and we'll discuss it. Thank you very much, and God bless us all always.